CC-130 that you see flying here is stationed at a 435 squadron in Winnipeg, Manitoba, which is also our Air Force headquarters location. And
you know,
also
I talked to Admiral Flatley. He said, we had 15 feet. There was plenty of room.
Oh, boy. Well, he received a Distinguished Flying Cross with more than 29 touch-and-go and a number of full-stop non-carrier-arrested landings in an aircraft that could weigh over 300,000 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, the Canadian Forces CC-130 Hercules. Well, Bruce, they do it like the United States Navy does it with the basket and the probe and drogue system, but I know you got your airplane to introduce. Take it away, my friend.
Alrighty, thanks, Rob.
We're about to start the show here. I'd like to thank the City of Cleveland to have us for the air show. We're making history here today. We're doing two shows in two different countries, and we're happy it's happening here in Cleveland. We're going to be with you shortly. Sit down, relax, and enjoy the show.
Demonstrate the awesome power ability and power capability of the Hornet. Watch as Pop performs his first maneuver, the Cuban 8. CF-18. Watch as Paco performs the double 540-degree roll. Look for the change in direction halfway through this next maneuver. Perform a loop, but very few can perform one like the Hornet. Watch now as Captain Gobeil sets up for the very demanding square loop. During the downward portion of this next maneuver, the aircraft will be in full afterburner, descending at over 30,000 feet a minute. After completing the maneuver, Pat will perform the very popular rudder roll reposition where the aircraft rolls around its nose. Now, with a 7G pull to the vertical, Captain Gobeil and the square loop.
Your voice.
and changing direction quickly, making it a hard target to adversaries. Pat will fly the aircraft in a minimum radius, 360-degree turn. During the turn, Pat will experience over 6 times the force of gravity.
CF-18 Hornet!